How's it going, y'all? Tyler Anderson here from Tyler's Reel Fishing on behalf of Skeeter Boats to bring you guys another episode of Skeeter School. Welcome to class. Before we even get to thinking about putting the cover on your boat, you want to make sure that you have cleared away the entire surface area of your boat from any valuables that you might want to take with you, and of course any sharp objects such as rods and reels or tackle boxes that could damage your cover. So once you have the entire boat cleared, you are ready to put your cover on your skeeter. Now, as you guys might have seen when I unfolded the cover, you can tell that because I folded it properly, as I'll talk about here in a second, the nose is super easily seen, and of course it gives you a great starting point on where to begin putting the cover on. So in a nice orderly fashion, you want to make sure that you start with the front of the boat just like this, putting the nose on, and then, like I said, if you have it folded properly, it should be relatively easy to just start unfolding it. And so when you're by yourself, you got to start on one side, and then once you've folded this here, you can go to the other side, unfold the little section you just did. Now, one common thing you're gonna find when you're putting your cover on, especially for the first time ever, or maybe it hasn't been used in a long time, is that you're gonna feel like it doesn't really fit. You're gonna kind of pull it and be like, I can't quite get it over the front. Oftentimes, your cover is caught on something. So whether you're caught on the trolling motor up front or something along the boat, your electronics mounts, you wanna make sure that you're kind of constantly, you know, walking along the boat here and pulling and checking things, because these covers, especially these Skeeter built covers, are built specifically for this boat. So it's gonna fit. You just have to make sure that you are kind of pulling everything, checking everything, and eventually you'll get the perfect fit that gets this cover nice and snug. So as we've worked our way from the bow of the boat back here to the stern, of course, you wanna make sure that your cover goes down over the classic Skeeter sponsons. And then on every Skeeter cover, you have a hook back here. You wanna make sure that, of course, this is hooked at the opposite direction in terms of pull from where it's coming from. And so you don't wanna hook your hooks to your jack plate, because it's gonna be hooking at an up angle. You don't wanna hook them to your power poles, really any accessories. You wanna hook them to the most sturdy thing directly underneath the cover. That way when you tighten it, that cover is secure to your boat. Now, every good cover out there for your boat is going to have some kind of ratchet strap to make sure that it's totally secure to your boat. But of course, before you even do this, you wanna make sure that you have all the other, you know, main straps on the boat. So here on my skeeter, I have two main straps here. The proper way is to go on the inside of the trailer, and then since it was used last time and I just unclipped it, it was a little bit shorter. Want to clip it like that and then exert a good amount of force. And of course, I don't want to tighten them up too much, because I have to do two on this side, two on that side, and I don't want to have too much cover pulled on one side and you get to the other side and the straps can't even reach because there's not enough strap left. So I want to do, of course, a good job clipping it, threading it underneath, and then tightening it down. But of course, once I have these two on there a little bit, I move on to the other side and do the exact same thing. Now, if your straps are too long like mine are, I have not had the chance to cut them down to size yet, you of course want to tie your straps down, that way they're not flapping around in the wind. So now that we have all of the straps connecting the cover to the trailer, I'm gonna do the last step, which is of course to ratchet it down to get it very tight. Now, the ratchet system here is actually a loop throughout the entire skeeter cover, and so I usually just end up ratcheting one side and it tightens the entire thing, but I have both clips, or both you know, cables attached to the back of my trailer, and I'm going to start ratcheting this thing down right here. Of course, you wanna make sure that you are getting your cable nice and straight, your cord nice and straight, and I ratchet kind of up to the point where, like this here, a little bit too loose, give it like three or four more, and once it starts getting like really tight against the side of my FXR, I kind of give it one more just like that, and of course it can be hit away nice and easy in the Velcro, and you are ready to either drive down the highway, stow it away in your storage facility, or put it in your garage. And of course, the main purpose of a cover is to protect it from the elements. Your boat is an expensive piece of equipment, it is an investment, and in order to have the most fun out there on the water, you want it to be functioning properly, and of course, looking good. But now that we've showed you guys how to properly put the cover on, let's show you how to take it off and fold it. That way you guys can have, like I said, the least frustrating cover experience possible. So now we are going to de-ratchet. That's the first thing you do. It's the last thing you do when you put the cover on. First thing you do when you take the cover off. And again, I'm gonna de-ratchet it. That way the cover is now loose. Shake it around a little bit, and then, as always, put this thing away nicely in the Velcro little strap here. Of course, you want to make sure all the straps are off and the cover is fully loose. You want to fold about a foot and a half to 2 feet at a time. And so I'm going to get about that much of a fold. When you're doing this by yourself, you're going to be doing a lot of walking around the boat. As you start getting up to the front of the boat here, you're going to have your main straps that go underneath the trailer. You're going to want to fling those on the inside. And then once you get, at least on my FXR, to the trolling motor area, you want to start folding it over just a little bit. Folding it over, I don't know, foot and a half again, 2 feet. Fold this side in a little bit. And with one more fold, again, you have the nose sticking out here to give you easy access next time. You're going to want to fold that in and give yourself one more. And you are done. Look at how organized that is. So that is the boat covering process for your Skeeter boat. Now, one thing I feel like I have to address is that you do not want to fold your cover up at all possible when it is damp or wet. That's gonna cause a situation where mold can grow or mildew can happen. And so if you can, when you take your cover off your boat, put it in a cool, dry place to dry this thing off before you fold it. I understand that's not always a possibility for a lot of you guys, but if and when you can, make sure you are folding your cover in a dry location. So this has been another episode of Skeeter School. My name is Tyler Anderson, and we'll see you guys next time. Man, let's just keep a rolling, man.